My name is Walter Hartwell White. I live at 308 Negra Arroyo Lane, Albuquerque, New Mexico, 87104. This is my confession.
Breaking Bad is the show audiences haven't stopped talking about in the US and throughout the world since it first aired in January 2008 and beyond its gripping finale in September 2013. Created by Vince Gilligan from the X-Files writer room, Breaking Bad follows the rise and fall of unassuming chemistry teacher Walter White, played by Bryan Cranston, and the great lengths that he goes to provide for his family.
I'm thinking, maybe you and I could partner up.
You want to cook crystal meth?
In season one, White is diagnosed with terminal lung cancer, which gets progressively worse as Breaking Bad develops. After a ride-along with his Drug Enforcement Administration agent brother-in-law Hank Schrader, played by Dean Norris, Walter White becomes curious in the world of methamphetamine production and money laundering, considering it as a viable way to pay for his growing medical bills. White begins cooking the purest meth seen in Albuquerque with his chemistry expertise and help from ex-student Jesse Pinkman, played by Aaron Paul, and discovers that providing for his family after he is gone isn't his only ambition. White later adopts the pseudonym Heisenberg and begins building his criminal empire. With only 62 episodes, Breaking Bad is listed in the Guinness Book of World Records as the most critically acclaimed show of all time.
You clearly don't know who you're talking to, so let me clue you in. I am not in danger, Skyler. I am the danger. A guy opens his door and gets shot, and you think that of me? No. I am the one who knocks.
Here are 17 Breaking Bad facts you haven't heard before about Walter White, including the name Aaron Paul's character, Jesse Pinkman, was originally going to be called, which actor has a Breaking Bad-themed tattoo, and what the props team used to portray Walter White's methamphetamine on the set of Breaking Bad. The US cable channel AMC ordered 9 episodes to be written for the entire first season, but the Writers Guild of America strike limited the production to just 7 episodes. In the original 9 episodes of season 1 of Breaking Bad, the show's creator Vince Gilligan planned to kill either the character Jesse or Hank as a bold, shocking ending, however it was canned due to the 7 episode limit. Jesse Pinkman's planned death was written as an accident during a drug deal gone wrong and would have been used as a device to plague Walter White with guilt.
Seriously, I got dudes that would give their left nut for a little more.
Great.
I'm just saying, I mean, if you ever, you know, saw your way clear to, you know, you and I cooking a little more.
Get the hell off my property.
Gilligan subsequently realized the acting strength both Aaron Paul and Dean Norris, who played Jesse and Hank, brought to their respective roles, so decided to keep them in the storyline. Hank became a pivotal character in Breaking Bad as White's unlikely antithesis. His realization that his brother-in-law was in fact the criminal mastermind the DEA have been searching for is one of the best moments in the show.
I don't even know what I'm talking.
If that's true, if you don't know who I am, then maybe your best course would be to tread lightly.
Equally, Aaron Paul's character Jesse, who looks up to Walter White as a father figure, was written into his own spin-off film documenting his story after the Breaking Bad finale. El Camino, a Breaking Bad movie, was released on Netflix in October 2019, 6 years after the original series had ended. The style of Breaking Bad is often widely discussed by fans and academics alike. Its genre-blurring neo-western crime thriller feel was predominantly achieved by Vince Gilligan's choice to shoot Breaking Bad mostly on 35mm film. The crew only used digital cameras when needed for secondary angles, point-of-view shots, and the signature time lapses. Gilligan and Breaking Bad cinematographer Michael Slovis originally wanted to shoot in CinemaScope, an anamorphic lens which was used in the 1950s and would have helped create their desired western look with wide landscapes, however AMC declined. Each episode of Breaking Bad had a budget of $3 million US to shoot by the end of season 5, which is much higher than the average cost of producing a cable television show in the United States. In the initial draft versions of the script, Breaking Bad was meant to be set in Riverside, California. However, Sony Pictures Television suggested Albuquerque, New Mexico, due to the attractive financial benefits and tax rebate offered by the state. The story itself changed location too, due to Gilligan's fear that the production crew would be fixated with avoiding the Sandia Mountains to the east of Albuquerque in every shot. It is said that each location shoot added $1 million to the local economy in Albuquerque.
You can't kill me. Because Jesse wouldn't cook for you if you did.
Vince Gilligan's whole motivation for writing Breaking Bad was to create a show full of charge, one that sees the main protagonist slowly drift into a role of an antagonist. When creating the character Walter White, Vince Gilligan wanted to succeed in the seemingly impossible task of taking a nerdy Mr. Chips type character and transforming him into Scarface. By season 4, Bryan Cranston, who played Walter White, described his character being well on his way to badass. During the 5th and final season, Vince Gilligan found it harder and harder to write for Walter White's dark persona, saying, "It'll be a relief to not have Walt in my head anymore."
Now, say my name.
Before creating Breaking Bad, Vince Gilligan worked as a writer on The X-Files. He immediately cast Bryan Cranston in the role of Walter White based on his previous work in season 6 of The X-Files in an episode Drive, where he played a prejudiced, terminally ill character who held Fox Mulder, played by David Duchovny, hostage. Gilligan said that he handled a mix of sympathetic and loathsome well, so figured that he was up to the difficult task of portraying Walt. Initially, the channel officials at AMC were skeptical of the casting choice, due to recognizing Cranston from his role in Malcolm in the Middle, a comedy series in which he played the larger-in-life character Hal. They approached actors including Matthew Broderick and John Cusack for the role of Walter White instead, but they both declined. Dean Norris, who plays DEA agent and Walt's brother-in-law Hank, also starred in The X-Files in the 22nd episode of the second season, F. Emasculata. Aaron Paul was also a former The X-Files guest in the episode Lord of the Flies.
Sometimes forbidden fruit tastes the sweetest.
Intrigued by his character, Bryan Cranston wanted to fill in the blanks left by Vince Gilligan's script and create the character's backstory so he could truly get into the role and mindset of Walter White. His preparation to play the Breaking Bad lead was both mental and physical. He gained 10 pounds of weight for the first season to again lose it all throughout the show, to add to Walter's decline in health from cancer. Cranston dyed his hair darker brown and worked with the Breaking Bad makeup artist Frida Valenzuela to create an impotent mustache, while similarly working with the costume designers to keep Walt's wardrobe as unremarkable as possible. Walt tends to wear dark greens, khaki, and brown.
My God.
Color is used throughout the film and television industry in varying degrees to reflect a character's mood, situation, and circumstances. Color acts as a psychological cue for audiences to learn even more about the character being portrayed. In Breaking Bad, the use of color in costume is quite striking, and Vince Gilligan has spoken in detail about his use of color theory in the show. Obviously, Walter and Skyler's surname is White. Skyler, played by Anna Gunn, is seen throughout Breaking Bad wearing monochrome beige outfits, and sometimes blue. Marie Schrader, played by Betsy Brandt, is always wearing purple. Hank is always in orange. Walter White's earth-toned wardrobe of greens and brown was used to make him blend into the background, but Gilligan shared in an interview with GQ magazine that he would intentionally start Walter off in one color at the beginning of the series, and then take him into a darker version of the color by the end, for example, red to black. For the final 8 episodes of season 5 of Breaking Bad, Jesse Pinkman wears exactly the same costume and only alters his appearance by taking off layers or adding them. On the last day of filming, Bryan Cranston was having drinks in the bar with the Breaking Bad cast and crew when they brought in a tattoo artist. He subsequently has a Breaking Bad themed tattoo on the side of his middle finger on his right hand. This small yet permanent memento from the show depicts the BR, bromine, and BA, barium, chemical elements from the periodic table used as the Breaking Bad logo.
You are done.
The 99.1% chemically pure blue sky meth created by Walter White and Jesse Pinkman on Breaking Bad was portrayed on screen by the props department as candy floss flavored rock, a type of cotton candy flavored rock candy in the USA. According to Bryan Cranston in an interview with presenters Kyle and Jackie O on Australia's Kiss 106.5, it tasted like vile pieces of sugar. Marius Stan, who plays Breaking Bad car wash owner Bogdan Wolinetz, is a real scientist with a PhD in chemistry from the Institute of Physical Chemistry of the Romanian Academy. After his part in Breaking Bad, Stan moved to work at the Applied Materials Division at the Argonne National Laboratory, operated by the University of Chicago, in a role using artificial intelligence to design better materials.
Fuck you! And your
eyebrows.
Jesse Pinkman, played by the actor Aaron Paul, is well known for his catchphrase, "bitch," in Breaking Bad. Throughout the 5 seasons, Pinkman says it a total of 54 times. First, his voicemail message in season 1, episode 2, which we hear when Skylar White calls back an unknown number ringing her home. Then lastly, when Jesse holds onto the bars over the underground room that he is being held captive in during episode 13 of season 5. When filming the Netflix film and Breaking Bad prequel El Camino in 2019, Paul realized there wasn't a bitch line in the script, so slipped it in during an improvised take, and the producers rightly kept it in.
This is my own private domicile and I will not be harassed. Bitch!
Just a quick interruption to say thank you so much for clicking on a January Media video. If you haven't heard of us before, then take a few seconds to open a new tab, type in januarymedia.co.uk, and we've got a whole host of other videos, articles and podcasts all about TV and film. So if you want to find out more facts, have a go at some of our quizzes, and browse our entertainment-themed shop, then make sure you visit januarymedia.co.uk after you watch this video. The house used as Walter and Skylar White's home in Breaking Bad is located on 3828 Piermont Drive in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and it has been privately owned for 41 years. The family who live there have had to put up with many visits from Breaking Bad fans looking for photo opportunities, and some have even gone as far as copying the memorable pizza on the roof scene from season 3, episode 2. According to the site Road Trippers, in 2015, the local Albuquerque Police Service patrolled the house 24/7 due to potential antisocial behavior.
We have discussed everything we need to discuss. I thought I made myself very clear.
You got dipping sticks.
Giancarlo Esposito, who plays Gus Fring, the owner of the successful Los Pollos Hermanos restaurant and associate of the cartel, was originally only meant to be a guest character starring in 3 to 4 episodes. However, he was asked to return for 7 episodes in the 3rd season. Esposito originally refused to rejoin the cast unless he could star in further episodes, so Gilligan included him in a total of 26. Esposito ended up replacing Hector Salamanca as the main protagonist in season 3, and he went on to star predominantly in Better Call Saul.
I think that you're confusing me for someone else.
I don't think I am.
Sir, if you have a complaint, I suggest you submit it through our email system. I would be happy to refer you to our website.
I was told that the man I would be meeting with is very careful. A cautious man. I believe we're alike in that way. If you are who I think you are, you should give me another chance.
I don't think we're alike at all, Mr. White. You are not a cautious man at all. Your partner was late, and he was high.
In season 5 of Breaking Bad, actor Jesse Plemons joins the cast as the ruthless white supremacist Todd Alquist. Due to his striking resemblance to fellow actor Matt Damon, Jesse earned the nickname Meth Damon. He later starred in the Netflix prequel to Breaking Bad, El Camino, as one of the main characters keeping Jesse Pinkman captive. You may also recognize Plemons from Fargo, where he played the character Ed Blomquist, and Charlie Brooker's Black Mirror, where he played Star Trek-themed Captain Robert Daly. Breaking Bad creator Vince Gilligan had initially named the character of Jesse Pinkman Marion Allen Dupree, who would always be known as his surname Dupree. However, we're glad that he didn't, as it just makes us think of Owen Wilson.
I can't now. It's gonna have to be you.
What? No way, man.
Listen to me. You're closer than we are. You'll have about a 20-minute lead. They've got me at the laundry and they're going to kill me.
Jesse, do it now!
Son of a bitch!
Do it fast!
Do it, Jesse!
When shooting the fight scene in season 1 of Breaking Bad between Tuco Salamanca and Jesse Pinkman, actor Raymond Cruz accidentally knocked Aaron Paul unconscious. This led to Aaron Paul seeking medical attention for concussion.
What is this shit? This is blue.
We use a different chemical process, but it is every bit as pure.
Each episode of Breaking Bad begins with the iconic black and green smoke titles with the show's logo, the BR and BA elements on the periodic table, bromine and barium. However, if you look closely, you can see the chemical formula C10H15N, which is actually the chemical formula for methamphetamine. You'll also be able to see 149.24, which is the molecular weight of meth.
Whoa, hey, this is private property.
Just a minute, I want to talk to you.
Look, lady, whatever you're selling, I ain't buying, yo.
Well, my name is Skylar White, yo. Do not sell marijuana to my husband.